Hi, I'm Mark Anderson of Panther Peak Bindery, and in this video I thought I'd talk about the three main types of adhesives used in bookbinding. There are many variants within each of these types, so let's just talk about them in a general way. The first we'll talk about is called PVA, or polyvinyl acetate. It's essentially a more purified form of Elmer's glue. PVA is very easy to use. It tacks up very quickly, which is a good thing or a bad thing. If you want to slow it down, people mix it with either wheat paste or methylcellulose. That gives one more working time with it. The downside is that most PVAs are not easily reversible, so you don't want to use it on a rare or valuable book because it'll be extremely difficult for a future conservator to try to take the book apart. But it's very commonly used because of its ease of use. This is hide glue or animal glue. I buy it in a gelatinous form. I think woodworkers buy it in pellets. It has many of the favorable qualities of PVA in that it adheres really quickly. You can slow down how quickly it adheres by adding water. It's also reversible, so a book with hide glue on the spine, which is where it's most often used, from 200 years ago can easily be taken apart by just adding a little bit of water. That's a very beneficial aspect of hide glue. Hide glue does need to be heated. As someone from Seattle, that always makes me a little nervous because the Great Fire of Seattle was started with a glue pot falling over. But this is an electric glue pot, so I'm not quite nervous that that will actually happen. But the downside to hide glue really is that you can't just use it as soon as you want it. You have to plan ahead, put the hide glue in the glue pot, add a little water, and let it heat up, and then work with it till it's the consistency you want it to be. PVA you just use straight out of the bottle, so it's much more convenient. This is wheat starch used to make wheat paste. Paste is used in covering leather books, but it's also used in paper conservation and repair of books. The advantage of paste is that it's easily reversible. The downside is that it doesn't have a lot of tack to it, so you need to have the two items you want pasted together held together while the item is drying. The other disadvantage of paste is that it has a rather short shelf life. So you can't make too much paste because it'll go bad in a week or two and then you have to start over again. And the highly purified forms of wheat starch that we use in binding is rather expensive. I do this. I make my wheat paste and then store it in these tubes and sterilize it. And then the shelf life, instead of being a couple of weeks, is several months. In general, I end up having to make paste maybe twice a year because I have these tubes. Within these three groups, there are several variations, of course. There's water-soluble PVA, which gives you the opportunity to work with a PVA that's fairly reversible. Within the high glues, there's fish glues and other types of glues that are used that are a little more purified and a little better conservationally to use than just straight high glue. And within paste, people use wheat paste, rice starch, even methylcellulose. But in general, I think this is a basic, good introduction, and I hope you enjoyed watching it.